All right, we're learning today a topic that is also interesting, also has to do with mystical creatures. For anybody that didn't see the mystical creatures, you have to see all the series of the mystical creatures, all the wolfmen, the werewolf, the vampires, the mermaids, there's few things that are varied at Ne'asadeh, a few things that are mamash, will take away your breath. And today, on the same topic, something that's now very hot, whoever listens a little bit to news can hear on many news sites reporting that the feds are warning a group of people that are vowed to go to what is called the Area 51 in Nevada. That's a military place, huge. And they're saying they're going there on September 20th from 3 to 6 a.m. The invading, and they want to see the UFOs. They want to see the aliens. And it's been taken, it's becoming viral. They have a Facebook page. Over a million people promised to show up over there. And it's becoming serious news. It's so much so that the feds got involved. The president was asked about it already a few times in the last 2 weeks, and he had to comment and tell his opinion whether there are aliens, there are UFOs, or there aren't. And he was pretty much skeptical about it. He didn't say yes. He didn't say no. He said that he himself is not a big believer in it, but he keeps an open mind. And the news keeps on speaking about it, and it's becoming a hit. And just a couple of days ago, President Trump spoke about it, and it's constant, and they're picking up a volume of people, over a million people. They're now, I think, by 1.2 million people that signed up to go over there. They have a name for it. They're saying the storming Area 51. They can't stop all of us. That's what the page is saying. And they're using wording like, show them, they want to see the aliens, show them to us. They have, the military has military pilots that have been testifying. They saw things that they could, they are pretty sure that are UFOs. They saw things that can't be explained in any other way. So we're talking about pilots that are very high officials in the army, in the military. And they're testifying to different things, and it's so much so that the American military spent last year $22 million in searching for UFOs, for evidence. So this is real. It's not something that was up to now. It was like something on the air that you wouldn't know. Maybe it's something that is more like a mashal or things that people imagined. And they had all kind of different videos of showing things that could be that all made up. But today, if military is willing to spend so much money, $22 million, if the feds are taking this seriously, if people are storming Area 51 on September 20th, so they're taking this seriously. They're taking this seriously. And we are here to find out, in our end, what does the Torah say about it? You know that the Torah has an opinion on everything. Torah, you'll find in the Torah opinion on everything. And we want to know today, does the Torah speak about UFOs, that the Torah speaks about aliens? And in order to open this, there's very famous Zohar in various places, and it's called normally Sheva Ha'aratzot, the seven lands. And as we see, as we learn this, that the way HaKadosh Baruch Hu created the world, says the Zohar, is like onion with different shichvot, different layers. That's the term the Zohar uses, which means there are seven different layers that each layer has a different world, physical. We're not talking anything spiritual today. Everything we're speaking today, according to the commentators of the Zohar, all speak about physical worlds, which means if you dig deep enough, There's a midrash that Mirai Ben Yoyada said that the depth to the next world is a length of 500 years of walking. So if you walk 500 years, you'll be able to reach the next world. As we'll see soon, we'll see all of that. In those different worlds, which means we have our own world, which is called Tevel, where we live, on top of the world, and then the six other layers going down. And those six worlds are not empty. They have over there a population of people, as we'll see right now. And those people have different characteristics. And they look very, very, some of them look very, very different than we do. For instance, I'll give you an example. You're all familiar with E.T., right? Some of us even grew on that fiction called E.T. And the Zohar explains that there's a world, actually, if you go two layers down, there's a world called Neshia. And the Zohar says that over there, you have creatures that are the feet, the legs are very, very tiny. Tzutzei raglaim, they have no feet. Just like if you ever see the E.T., he doesn't have any legs. He just has feet coming out from his belly or whatever. And the face is without any nose. So you have only two holes, says the Zohar. En lahem af rak shnei nekavim, and they're very, very small. So that's mamash, if you can guess, I would see in front of my eyes the feature of E.T. But that's what it is in the Shia. That's a Zohar in few places. Those creatures, as we're going to learn about it in the Zohar, we read about it, sometimes, the Zohar says, are able to come to visit our world. Now, if you have an E.T. visiting our world, or you have a man as one of the features that live on those worlds, with two heads coming to visit our world, and we see him, obviously he doesn't walk on the ground, he has his own way of living, we see him flying or even walking on the ground, here you have yourself an alien, a UFOs, according to Toratenu HaKedoshah. So I want to read you over here what the Torah says. The Torah says, I'm reading it right now, I'll read various places, I'll give you the Marei Mekomot, this is all from the Zohar HaKadosh. The Zohar says, in Sefer Vayikra Daftet Amud Bet, Zain Shechakim Le'ela, V'chol Chad V'chad Kochavim U'Mazorot. Just like you have on top, seven different layers, says the Zohar, of sky, of atmospheres, V'shamashim Dim Shamshim V'chol Rekia V'rekia, U'V'chol Hu Me'ilen Retichin Ilen Alilen. You have over there Markevot. Markevot, we're not going into the terminology, Kabbalistic terminology, but there's something called Markevot, one on top of the other. All of them are accepting the yoke of Hashem. They all have markevot and shamashim, those that serve HaKadosh Baruch Hu. That's on top. And the Zohar keeps on explaining, minhon de vav gedfin, minhon de dalet gedfin. Some of them have six wings, some of them have four wings, whatever that means. I'm going to the next piece in the Zohar, and he says that the same way that you have that, chulu rekiin ilen al ilen kegildei betzalim, all those like layers of onions. You peel the first layer, you're up to the next layer. Ilen letata v'ilen le'ela. Just like you have on top, you have that on the bottom and the ground. They all go according to Hashem's will, and they also camp on Hashem's will. It says over here that, I'm reading you the Zohar again, the same way you have seven layers on top, on heaven, same way, says the Zohar, you have seven layers, just like the onion layers, on under the ground. V'chul hu b'yishuva, all of them have population. Kulu b'yishuva bar, milen ilayin ve'ilen tatayin. Ve'eretz Yisrael ila amekula. Eretz Yisrael, we live in our world, which is called Tevel, is the highest. And Eretz Yisrael is even higher than all of them, as it says in the Torah, v'kamta ve'alita el ha'makom ahu, says the Gemara, in the fourth parak of Kiddushim, right away in the beginning, that Mikan Sheretz Yisrael gavoa mikol haaretzot, veYerushalem ilaa mikol yeshuvah. Who's the highest from all? Yerushalayim is even higher than that. So that's just to give you a peek of a little bit, a taste of what we're starting to learn over here. And now, the Zohar in Bereshit, Zohar Chadash we're reading right now, Bereshit Daftet, explain to us more in details what happens in those worlds. Actually, each world has a name. HaKadosh Baruch Hu gave a name to each world. And the Zohar says the following. Sidura de'alma b'sheva kitrin sgalgelan, sheva aratzot inun dal el amida. You have seven layers, one on top of the other. Kemad inun shiva rikim. Just like we explained right now, the seven skies and seven worlds under. What the names of those? Dal el amida ve'inun. Eretz, we're going from the bottom, which means the most inner world within our world. If you dig deep enough into the core, what world do you have over there? It's called Eretz. That's the inner one. Adama is the next one over that. Arka, Gei, Neshia, Tzia, these are six, and the seventh one would be Tevel. That's our world over here. Le'ela mikulhu tevel dichtiv u'ishpot tevel betzedek. That's what the pasuk in Tehillim. Tet says, HaKadosh Baruch Hu will judge tevel betzedek. He will judge tevel. So now, before I even explain that, before we go even into that, I want to tell you that this is not something that the scientists in any way like refuse or deny. There are those that claim that there is such a thing. And it's a known theory that there's a hollow earth. You ever heard the terminology, the hollow earth? It was by Edmund Halley, which was an astronomer. He died actually in 1742, and he came up with different calculation that he saw that you can't make sense of the world unless you explain that the world is hollow. And he explained that same things that we're reading, that there are different worlds within our world. But he even said something fascinating, that those worlds within our world have their own sun, and they have oxygen, and therefore they have an ability for people to live in them. Now, what does the Torah say about this? When you read those things in the Zohar HaKadosh, the Zohar explains that there is a sun in some of those worlds. Some of those worlds are completely dark. Some of those worlds have a sun. And before we read the Zohar inside, I want to tell you briefly what the Zohar is going to say. So when we read the Zohar, you can easily follow along. So Eretz, which is the most inner place, we call this Eretz, is a dark place without any light. This is the core of the Gehenom. This is the worst place of all. The Zohar explains that Adam HaRishon, when he sinned, he was punished to go to Eretz. That place was a very scary place. The Adam HaRishon was very frightened. Not only that it doesn't have any light at all, but also it has what is called Cherev HaMitapechet. There's a certain sword from both sides that doesn't allow you to do anything. If you do something, boom, it chops you. So that's a very scary place. After Adam HaRishon made Teshuvah, HaKadosh Baruch Hu lifted him to the next world. That world is called Adama. Adama has already stars and constellation. Within that world, we live in our world, we have different stars and constellation. Within that world, this is the theory that we explained before from Halley, that there is stars, constellation. As soon as we see worlds that have even a sun, this world over there has people that are, says the Zohar, that are constantly sad. They're never happy. They do have a way to plant seeds and eat, but they're never able to have seeds of grain. All kind of different things, all types of grass and vegetables, but not grain, because grain represents being smart, as we see that Etzadat, Rav Yudah says in the Gemara, Etzadat was chita. It says in Brachot Daf Mem, Shein atinok yodea likro abba ve'ima ad she'itom tam chita, tam dagan, which means, when does a baby get his wisdom? When he's able to eat dagan. Dagan represents five of the different grains, wheat, barley, oats, and so on. So the Midrash Rabbah says, kadlo have bebar nash de'a, when you see a person that doesn't have brains, people speak like that. It's something that people say. When you see a person that doesn't have brains, inu namre lo achala ugavra pita dechitin minyoma. The people say, that's a saying of people, this person never eats bread. never eats dagan, never eats one of the five grains, and that's why he doesn't have any wisdom. Me'matay marchikin, says the halacha, says the gemara, mitzvah shel katan. When is a katan? You know that when you want to say a bracha, you want to learn Torah, and there's a waste of a baby, you have to stay away from it. You have to remove it. You can't learn over there. But that's only mishetam tam dagan, only when he's able to eat dagan. Beforehand, it doesn't have any meaning. It's all because, as the gemara explained, dagan makes a person smart. Those people don't have, as we see all those worlds, don't have an ability to plant dagan. They can plant in some places vegetables. In the next world, arka and so on, again, eshia, they can even plant trees of fruits, but they can never plant tevua, grain that would fill them up and give them wisdom. So it says over there that it says, the Zohar explains that it has stars and constellations. They plant in there. People are constantly are not happy. They constantly sad. And who lived there first? Adam Rishon. Because the Kadosh Baruch Hu uplifted him from Eretz to Adama when he made Teshuvah. Now, in Adama, Adam Rishon lived 130 years. And he lived with Lilit, which is Esheda. And he was able to give birth to many, many, many children that live in there. And all the descendants that you have in there now, living in there, right now as we're talking, says the Zohar, are all the descendants of Adam Arishon. Now obviously, we're all descendants of Adam Arishon, but soon you'll see that there's different groups of descendants. That takes us to the next world. The next world is Arka. Arka, says the Zohar Kadosh, has a sun as well, shining constantly. And people plant in there, not only vegetables, but they plant also trees in there, which means you have also fruits. Or you have over there the descendants of Cain. When Cain sinned, so HaKadosh Baruch Hu threw him also all the way to Eretz, which was a scary, scary place. When Cain made the Teshuvah, HaKadosh Baruch Hu lifted him not to Adama, but rather to Arka. And now Cain had a lot of children, and the descendants of Cain are in Arka. In Arka you have, says the Zohar, giants people, giants, and you have midgets. You have very small people. Giants and small people. That's what you have in Arka. Now in Arka, people's brain are not completely formed yet. So they're not smart at all. Part of it is we're saying right now, because they're not able to plant tevua. But they are able, says the Zohar, to give birth, and they die just like regular human beings, just like in all other worlds, but they don't have that wisdom to them. The next world over that is what is called Gei, which is a place that's very large, very big. Again, people plant in there. The Zohar makes a point to show how people eat, what people plant. Over there, you have the descendants of Dor, Migdal Bavel, the Bavel Migdal that they made, HaKadosh Baruch Hu was mefazer otam me'al pnei kol haaretz, and he sent them over there. By the way, when we are talking about Cain and Hevel, what did Cain say that HaKadosh Baruch Hu threw him into Eretz? Cain said, "En gerasht oti ayom me'al pnei adama," you threw me away, you expelled me from Adama, which means even Adama I didn't get. I'm going all the way down to Eretz. Ve'hayiti nad Vana ba'aretz. So Cain went all the way down to Eretz, and then when he made Teshuvah, HaKadosh Baruch Hu lifted him to the third world, which is Arka. In Gei, you have over there Tzetzai, Dor, Migdal Bavel. And they are much wiser than the other people in the other worlds. In that world, you have a lot of wealth. You have over there gold. You have over there good stones, and so on. Next world after that is Neshia. Neshia in Aramaic is called Neshia. When you want to say somebody forgot something, it's Nashe, which means Neshia is Melashon, forgetting. Those people that we explained that looks like an E.T. feature are constantly forgetting everything. They don't remember anything. That's the Zohar makes a point to tell us this idea. Now again, we spoke about who's those people that live in there, but the Zohar also tells us that those that from Migdal Bavel were separated not only to Gei, also to Neshia, and also to Tziah, which is the next world. Tziah also is a place that's completely dry, doesn't have any water at all. And the people that live in there, says the Zohar, are beautiful people, they're very good looking. But since they don't have water, they have craving to get water from Tevel. This is our world. So once in a while, they'll go up to look for water. And that's why sometimes you'll see such a thing. The Zohar explains in different places that the Chachamim were able to see those that came up. For instance, if you want to see a case like that, says the Zohar the following. The Zohar speaks about Rabbi Nehorai that actually went down. Rabbi Nehorai, this is the Zohar in Vayikra, Daf Yud Amud Bet. Rabbi Nehorai Saba Parish Le'am Araba. He went on the boat cruise. V'itragesh Yama, and the ocean started becoming well. V'itabedu kol linun davu ba'arba. All the people in the boat died. They all drowned. I guess maybe the boat flipped or whatever it was. V'itrachesh lenisa, he had a miracle. V'nachat b'shvilin yadian b'liba deyama. HaKadosh Baruch Hu took him with that miracle into roots that took him exactly to the world under. Nafak techot yama lishuvah chada, he went to a populated place underground. V'chama minun b'riyan, he saw those that we spoke about, those different creatures. Kulun zeirin, all of them were very tiny, very small. V'avu metzalitzlot, and they pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. They all have connection to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Zohar keeps on saying that in different places. V'lo yadam haikamu, but he couldn't understand them. If you ever heard E.T., you can't understand what he's saying. So they can't understand what they were saying. He couldn't understand Rabbi Nehorai what they were saying. Itrachish lenisa, v'salik. HaKadosh Baruch Hu saved him and pulled him up again to the world, to this world. Amar, he came out and he said the following words, says the Zohar. Zakayin inun tzadikaya. How great are the tzaddikim, the Talmidei Chachamim, that reveal to us those things. So, Nehorai, as we see soon, it was doubtful about such a thing. You want to tell me that this different worlds under this world doesn't look to me like anything that could really be. So, says Rabbi Nehorai, Zakayin inun tzaddikaya, the mishtad lebeoraita, v'yadin stimin derazei ilai. They know all the secrets of the world that nobody else knows. V'ailinun defligu al milayu velo mehem. Oy, for those people that don't believe on them and they argue with them. There's no way you can argue on people that know the secrets of the world. Says the Zohar, whenever Rabbi Nehorai went to Bet Midrash, to the shul, to learn, he heard Divrei Torah, have a bachi, always cry. So people saw him in the shul, in the yeshiva, in the Bet Midrash, crying. They tell him, why are you crying? Why are you crying? Amar lon begin de avarna al memnuta de mile de rabanan, because in the past I didn't believe what Chachamim told, what Chachamim said. They said the seven layers, six layers underground. I didn't believe that. Umistafena midina dehu alma, and now I'm scared because I doubted Chachamim. The Gemara, the Zohar, explained to us within those things that we just read, and I told you that on the outside, we will see them inside. Also, those things that we know today as a fact, although in history the scientists didn't believe it. What are the Zohar saying? In the same page over here in Daf Yud, says the Zohar that you should know, b'sifra derav emnun asava parish atir, da kol yeshuva mitgalgalin b'igula kekadur. The world is like a ball, kekadur, ilen letata v'ilen lela. Sometimes people are on top, sometimes people are on the bottom. People read this in the Zohar. They didn't understand. How could that be? The world is flat and there's nobody on the top. Everybody's on top and not on bottom. Otherwise, it would fall. Says the Zohar, no. So this is a famous Zohar, but it's the same place to show you that just like those things that nobody back then in history believed, and he didn't agree with the Zohar, and now everybody knows that the world is round and people are on the bottom and the gravity holds them on the ground. Just same thing with the other things that we are right now skeptical. We're saying maybe yes, maybe no, what the Zohar is saying. It doesn't sound so true. Says the Zohar, no, it's in the same passage, which is in the same breath. Every person in the world looks differently, right? So the Zohar tells you, if you go to China, you see different people different than us. Now, when the Zohar spoke, nobody went to China, and nobody from China came here. So what are you talking about? People live all over the world, they look all the same, they're all the same. We know that it's not like that. Wherever you go in the world, you have people looking very different, very, very different than people from the other place. Kefum kol atar v'atar v'kaimim b'kiyumayu k'shar b'nei nasha. Al da it atar b'yishuva k'dair le'elan, says the Zohar, there is in the world places that in one place it's light, chashich leilen. In the same time, it's dark for the other. It doesn't make any sense. If the world is now light, it's day all over. How could it be that in one side of the globe would be dark, on the other side light? It doesn't make any sense. Today we already understand everything. Leilen yamama, leilen elia. One place is night, one place is day. V'itatar dekule mama. Some places are constantly always day. Says the Zohar. Unbelievable. Now you have to say, Rav Shimon Bar Yochai never went traveling like Columbus did all over the world to know this information, right? So he tells you there are places in the world, itatar dekule yamama, all year is light. And how long is the night over there? A moment. Small moment, small hour, and right away it goes into day. He keeps on explaining this in length, and within that Zohar, he says what we said before. Same Zohar. Zayin shrakim le'ela, kol chad v'chad kochavim u'mazalot, v'shamashim dimshamshin, and so on and so forth. So that we saw. Says the Zohar, Sidura de Alma, this is Zohar in Bereshit Daf Tet, Sidura de Alma b'sheva kitrins galgelan, sheva ratzot inun, da le'ela min da, what's the name of this ratzot again? Eretz, adama, arka, gein, eshiya, tziya, tevel, le'ela mikulu tevel, dichtiv u'shpot tevel, b'tzedek, we saw that. Kad nafak adam mikinda de Eden, v'itetarech metaman, when HaKadosh Baruch Hu punished Adam Rishon, he threw him out of Gan Eden, itram elahu dikre Eretz, he went all the way down to Eretz. Diu atar chashich, it's a dark place. Letaman niru klum, no light whatsoever. Lo meshamesh klum, there's no constellations, no stars. Kivan de Adam al taman, dachil dechilu sage. When he went there, says the Zohar, he got very scared. Ulat acherev al mitapechet was there, the sword. Have a melata because sitrin God awaret. Kivan de nafak Shabbat, after he made teshuva, Shabbat passes, Motzei Shabbat, Yirer b'tshuva, Arem lekut shabrichu, Veselek le'elahu, Atar di'itka adama. He picked him up to adama. Dichtiv, Shalcheu Hashem Elokim migan Eden, La'avod et ha'adama. Kadosh Baruch Hu threw him, now it uplifted him to adama. Ba'ai it ne'iru de'na'er, over there you do have light, Diokanin de'kochvei ha'mazalef, from stars and constellation. Taman tziurin devnei nashai la'in, Guvrin de'nfaku me'adam kadma. All there, you have the descendants of Adam Rishon, that was born b'me'ahut latin shenin. On the 130 years that he was there, the kavu meshamesh beruach nukve, ve'inu nativim tadir, they constantly said, they have no reason to be happy over there. Let baruch edvan, not happy. Ve'ilen meshatete ve'nafkele alma da. Sometimes they go out, and they come to this world, tevel. Here you have, again, the UFOs that comes from Adama. U'mitapchim lesitra bisha, and then they become sometimes evil. U'me'adran taman ve'tzalan tzlota. They also pray. U'mitashvim beduchtayu taman. Then they go back over there and they sit in there and so on and so forth. Go into the next one. Kevan dechata Kain. When Kain sinned, achid la'kadosh baruch hu lahu atar dikre eretz. HaKadosh Baruch Hu threw him to eretz. Just like it says, gerashto oti hayom me'al pnei adama ve'itina ve'nad ba'aretz. HaKadosh Baruch Hu took him out of adama, put him in eretz. Begin detaman itcha itdachya v'itarach. Ve'yakol mutzi argeni. He said, every person that would find me over here would kill me because you have the la'at acherev amitapechetz. He got scared. Slick le'akadosh baruch hu le'arka ve'avetaman v'olid benin. He started giving birth to children. Where? In arka. That's the next world. Uve'arka itne'iru de'ne'ir migoshim shah. Over there you have a star. Zarin zarin, natin ilanin, letaman chitin. Kol inun de'taman, everybody in arka, inun mitoldot kain. All of them are the descendants of kain. Minon guvrim milain, some are very tall and big. Minon zirim, some are very small. Let lao. They don't have a mind like others, which means a full mind. They're not wise in any way. Adam have be'adama, adoli chet. Umitaman salek le'ala, arba dargin mikain. Chet went up. Now he explains. Next world. Gay. Ha'u be'emtzaud de'elav et ata. Daikre gay ben hinom. Which means you have over there the genom. Now it's interesting that you have a Gemara. Open Gemara. The Gemara says in Shabbat. Gemara in Shabbat Lametet says that there's something called Chamet Tveria. So anybody that was in Tveria in Eretz Yisrael, hot water that come from underground, like a well, hot water from the well that come from underground. So there's a machloket in the Gemara if they are toldot ha'ur or toldot ha'chama, a day hot because of the sun or because of the fire? Fire, where does fire? Rabbanan Amre Toldot Ha'ur Shechalfi Hapitcha De Gehenom. Rabbanan says that it is exactly on top where the Gehenom has a certain pipe, so to speak, that pushes over there, and that's why it's hot. The heat comes from a pipe from Gehenom. So it says the Zohar, Gei, Daihu Bimtzu De'ela Le'etata, Daikre Gei Ben Hinom. Urtzua Chada Nafka Mitaman Le'ela Le'aitevel. And there is a pipe that goes from that place all the way to Tevel, where we live, with Tevel. Ve'ikre of hachi gei ben henom. That's called gei ben henom. Taman pitcha de genom. Over there is the opening of genom. Now, I said something very interesting on Shabbat a couple of weeks ago. You have a chumash that I can see for a second? We said in the chumash that Moshe Rabbeinu has a machloket with Korach. Thank you. Korach starts arguing with Moshe Rabbeinu, starts doubting Moshe Rabbeinu. So Moshe Rabbeinu gives a certain prayer that changes. And he asks that things would be done in a way that sounds very strange. And let's see how it works in the parasha. The parasha says like this. When Moshe Rabbeinu asks that HaKadosh Baruch Hu should create a new creation, that Korach and his people would go underground. So what's the Lashon that Moshe Rabbeinu uses? He says like this, Im kemot kol ha'adam yemutu nelu fkudat kol ha'adam yipaked anem lo ha'shem shelachan. If they'll die normally, Hashem didn't send me. That would not be a proof that Hashem sent. Ve'im b'riya yivra Hashem. But if Hashem makes a new creation in the world, u'patzta ha'adama et piya, and the adama opens its mouth, which means the land would open its mouth. The land would swallow them. They'll go into the ground alive. Now, chayim she'olad, they'll live underground alive. And the Gemara says, and there's a midrash that says, that Korach and his people are still alive underground, and they constantly, on certain timing, scream, Moshe emet, v'torato emet, v'em badaim. How do they live in there alive? How do they live in there alive? My son asked me, how they live? My son asked me, I told him this. He said, what? How do they live in there? I don't understand how they live underground. And it says over here that they were punished to go chayim she'ola. But what was Moshe Rabbeinu asking? That Adama should open up. Patzta Adama et piya. The land open up. And all of a sudden, the pasuk changes words. What happened? We spoke about Adama, where the Eretz came from. Now the land, the Eretz, open up the mouth as well. What does that mean? But according to the way we explain right now, it's beautiful. There is Adama, there is Eretz. Moshe Rabbeinu didn't want that people should go all the way to Eretz. They hope that they'll do teshuvah. When you do teshuvah, just like Adam Rishon did, so you don't have to be in Eretz, you could be in Adama. In Adama, at least you have a sun, you have people, it's not so dark, you don't have, it's not as scary. Eretz is completely scary, but Korach didn't do teshuvah. Since he didn't do teshuvah, so what Moshe Rabbeinu said, that Adama should open the mouth, the Adama indeed, as the low, low, deep Adama opened up the mouth and was ready to swallow them and not further. But since Korach didn't do teshuvah, he went all the way down to Eretz. Now, who did teshuvah? Who did teshuvah was Korach's children. And if they did teshuvah, why did they go underground? The Gemara says that makom nifzar lahem, makom gavoa nifzar lahem b'sheol, b'gehenom b'sheol. They got a high place. Now, I ask the question, who cares if they got a high place, a low place? Once a person is underground, he dies, and what's the difference where you are? But according to the way you're explaining, it's beautiful. Because a high place is much better to live than a low place. They did teshuvah in the last minute. They are in a higher place in those worlds. And could be they are in Eretz or in Gei, as we explained right now. But they are in a higher place. By the way, it says over here, when you take a look, it says, V'ardu chayim she'ola, she'ola without a vav. I saw the mefarshim ask over here why it's missing a vav, and they saying because they went down six medore genom, chiva medore genom, which is six. But according to the way we're explaining, it's beautiful. They went all the way down six lands underground to all the way what we call Eretz. So that's that would fit very, very nicely what we're saying over here. The Zohar explains here that there is Neshia, and over here are those ET features, Bnei Nasha Ketuin Zeirin, they don't have any legs, they cut their legs. Let alone Chotmim, they don't have a nose. Bartren Nukvin, they only have two holes over here where they breathe from, the Nafka Barucha. V'chol Madavdi Miad Mishtakr, anything they do, they forget right away. Al Derech Ikri Neshia, that's why it's called Neshia. Next world, upper, is Tziyahu, Atar Kishme, Beyabushta de Kula, Taman, Nenasha, Shapirun, Bechazu, they look over there, good. Umigod Da'u Tziyah, Kad Yadeh, Atar, De Mekor, De Mayin, Avin, Alin, Taman, whenever they found out there's on top, on our world, water, they see this water, they go over there. And that's where you see those people. So now, when we try to see those cases, I'll give you an example of what it says in the Zohar, Parashat Vayetze, Daf Kuf Nun Zayin Amud Aleph. It says like this, Rav Chiya v'Rav Yossi Avu Az LeBerorcha. They went on the road. Those two chachamim, Rav Chiya v'Rav Yossi. Amar l'Rav Yossi l'Rav Chiya, b'chol zimna d'azlin b'orcha, as long as we're walking on the road, ule'e'nan b'oraita, and we are learning Torah, kud shabrichu marchish l'nisa. HaKadosh Baruch Hu will make us a miracle. If we are walking on the road, and we learn Torah, HaKadosh Baruch Hu will make us a miracle. Hashta, urcha d'ka'arichlan, we're going on a long road, Nitasek beoraita, kut shabrichu, izdavek beadana, Kadosh Baruch Hu will be together with us, will be miracles. So they started saying divrei Torah. Says the Zohar, az liyat v'gabek b'ki detinara. They went and they sat on a top of a rock. Salik lon chad bar nash. All of a sudden, out of the rock comes out a small person. You know, it's like you walk down on the desert today. You can, in Eretz Yisrael, you walk down the desert, all of a sudden a tunnel could open up and you'll see six Palestinians, lo alenu. But over there, that's the case. All of a sudden, somebody comes from underground, opens up an opening on the rock, and comes out. Tevahu, they were amazed. What is that? And our creature, you know, we're talking about we're talking about a UFO, we're talking an alien. It doesn't look like a regular human being. So, whoop, what is that? Amar Rav Yossi, manant! Rav Yossi asked him, who are you? Abar me'anshe arka anan. I'm coming from the world called Arka. Amar lon v'taman it bnei nasha. Over there we have people. Amar, he asked him, you have people there? Amar in, zarin v'chatzdin. We live over there, we plant, with this. Minayu b'chezu achara meshanyan minay, v'salikna gibayu, leminda minayu, mashme d'arad atunba. Anyway, makes a long story short, they look to the right, they look to the left, the person goes down, and it disappears. Now, when we're talking about this, there is a Gemara in Menachot. Gemara in Menachot, Daf Lamed Zayin, the Gemara says over there, that by mine plimu mi Rebbe, Chacham, his name was Plimu, he asks Rebbe, mi sheyesh lo shnei rashim, be'eze mehem aniach tefillin, let's say you have a person that has two heads, so which head should he put the tefillin? Amar le, so Rebbe thought, he's making fun of him, such a question, you're making fun of me? We're learning Torah over there, it's a serious matter, you're making fun of me? Amar le, o kum gli, o kabel alach shmata, you have a choice, either you go out and you exile yourself, go out of town, or you accept yourself that you'll be for a certain while excommunicated. So while he was getting his punishment, Hadeachi, while they were talking still, Ata Ugavra, all of a sudden the person walks in the door to ask the rabbi a question in Halacha. Marle Ityalid Liyanuka. He tells him, I have a newborn. The Itle Tre Rasha, and he has two heads. Kama Baina Lelemet Avla Kohen. He's a newborn. I need to do Pidyon HaBen. How many do I give? 5 slaim or 10 slaim? Is he one person or two people? That is the Gemara. Says Tosfot over there, you should know, in this world, you don't have, that's a defect. You know, that's very uncommon to have two heads. Ba'olam hazeh leika. Avli yesh b'midrash. The Midrash says the following. Ashmedai, that's the king of the coast. Otzi mitachat karka adam echad sheyesh lo shnei rashim. Ashmedai, the story over there, this Tosfot brings. And the Midrash says that one time Ashmedai came to Shlomo HaMelech, which was the wisest in the world, and he asked Shlomo HaMelech, are you the wisest person? Shlomo HaMelech said, that's what HaKadosh Baruch Hu told me. So Ashmedai told him, you want to see something you never saw in your life? He said, of course, let me see something new. Ashmedai pulls his hand, boom, he picks up a person with two heads. Shlomo HaMelech was amazed. He was stunned. So Ashmedai went for a while. While this was happening, Shlomo HaMelech calls Bnei Ben Yoyadai shows him. He says, yeah, we learned about this in we mekubal, that there are worlds underground with such people with two heads. So then after a while, when Shlomo HaMelech already saw what he saw, he told the person, do you want to go back to your home? So he said, of course, I want to go back home. So he called the Shmedai, he told him, take him back home. He said, no, I can't. Once I pull somebody out, I can't put him back. Okay? So this person married a woman. That's already in that Tosfot. הוציא מתחת קרקע אדם אחד שיש לו שני ראשים לפני שלמה המלך, נשא אישה הוליד בנים כיוצא בו בשני ראשים וכיוצא בה בראש אחד. He had a boy with two heads, and he had other boys with one head like his wife. Now, one day, the father with the two heads dies. So they have to share what the father left. So the man with the two heads says, I deserve two parts. I'm a two-man person. Mm-hmm. It goes by the head. Give me two parts of whatever our father left. The brother said, no way. What do you mean? You're one person. You happen to have two heads, but you're one person. Back and forth, they said, let's go speak to Shlomo HaMelech. He'll decide. They went to Shlomo HaMelech. Shlomo HaMelech, wow, that's such a question he never got before. He told them, let me sleep overnight. The next day, he came up with a solution. He said that, bring the person with the two heads in front of me. He asked his servant to cover his head, one of the heads covered, that he's not going to see anything that happens. He warmed up, he asked the servant to warm up water, and when he warmed up hot water, he poured it on the other head. And all of a sudden, both heads started screaming. So he tells him, what are you screaming? It's not your head, it's somebody else's. You see from here, you're one person. That's the case of Shlomo HaMelech with the story. But you see, there are such features that the Gemara, now you have to understand, when we're talking about UFOs, it's not only underground, you also have on top, because there are poskim, kadmonim, huge rabbis that believe that there are UFOs on top as well, not only from underground. For instance, Rav Yehuda Barzeloni, he's called Kuzari Asheni, writes openly that there are UFOs, there are aliens. Sefer HaBrit writes in length about such things. He says that there are creatures in other worlds as well. And Saadia Gon Chasdai, he wrote the Sefer Or Hashem, writes the same thing. And the proof to that many bring is that Devorah sings, Shirat Devorah, in Shoftim Heikav Gimel, she says, Oru Meroz, Amar Malach Hashem, Oru Aror Yoshvea, Kilo Ba'u Le'ezrat Hashem B'Giburim. What does that mean? Oru Meroz, says the Gemara, in Moed Katan Tetzain, what's Oru Meroz? It's a certain star. There's a star in Shamayim, in the sky, that's called Meroz. And over here, she curses that star. Oru Meroz, Meroz is cursed, Amar Malach Hashem. The angel of Hashem says, Oru Aror Yoshvea, who's cursed? Those that sit on that star is called Meroz. Ki lo ba'u le'ezrat Hashem, le'ezrat Hashem b'gibur. She should have came to help us in the war. They didn't come to help us in the war, they are cursed. So comes the Mefarshim that we explained before, and they say, you see from here that there are those that live in other worlds. They have over there aliens, they have over there certain population that could come and help us in a time of need. That's one of the sources that they bring. This is also known from the Rebbe Milubavitch, where he was asked this question, are there any aliens that come from other worlds? He says, absolutely. And he says, this is a proof. Well, we don't need to speak about it much, he said, but you have over here a straight out proof to that thing. So we did over here touch on few things, very, very, you know, it was just on the tip of the top of the of you, so it's just so we can feel it a little bit. There's much more that have to do with that. Again, I encourage everybody to go and see the mystical creatures. Unbelievable. You go to rabbishaitahan.com, rabbishaitahan.com, and the mystical creatures, or you type my name, Shai Tahan, mystical creatures, you Google, it comes up. Beautiful series of what the Torah believes, and you'll find over there beautiful things about what the world has, and we don't even know, and you'll enrich your knowledge, and this is one of the things. Thank you very much for coming tonight.
Wow. This is so, you know it all.
Wow, that's amazing.
Wow. Wow.